Hello everybody and welcome to this demonstration, which is about using palette knives with acrylic. Palette knives can be less accurate than brushes and less versatile, but there are some distinct advantages. The first one is that they're very easy to clean because all you have to do is wipe them off on a rag or a piece of paper towel. They can be a lot cheaper than brushes. They're great for building thick texture and a broken colour effect. You can use the edge of them to create straight lines. You can scrape off errors that you've made in the painting, and you can use them to scratch in detail. You don't need to have a lot of different palette knives. This was a cheap set that I bought from C-White, and all you need is a number of different sizes. However, if you don't have any palette knives, you can just use a cut-up credit card or membership card. Here's one that I've cut up into three different sizes so that I can use the bigger one to scrape paint on, the thinner one for smaller areas, and the tip of this little one I can use to just dab little dots of colour. The topic this week is a sunset, and I've printed out a photograph that I took from my parents' house, and it's looking across a snowy field, and I liked this echo of blue from the sky reflecting in the snow in the field. And the palette needs to be something flat so that you have the room to scrape off the paint. You can't use a palette with a weld because you can't fit the palette knife into it. So something like a tray or a plate with a large central area would be perfect. The technique for mixing the colours is the same as for mixing with a brush. So you always start with the lighter colour and add darker colours to it. So I'm going to start with the golden brown orange at the bottom. And using the side of the brush, I scrape through and then push back through the paint repeatedly to blend it. So I'm using a twisting my wrist action here to scrape, push, scrape, push, and gradually work all of that colour through. And when I'm ready, I just clean off the palette knife and I'm ready to go again. So now some of the blues. It's much harder to pick up the paint when it's a wetter paint like this one. So my personal preference is to have a more heavy-bodied colour. Take a bit of that over here and add some more blue to it so that I have a darker version of the same colour. And some more down here. So now I just load up paint on the back of the palette knife, ready to go with the edge that I'm going to use, and I can start at the bottom and push it upwards. So if I want a shorter amount of paint, I can hold it quite vertically and get a little line like that. But if I want it to spread further, then I twist it, lower the angle, and that allows me to just push it further up. Once I've finished with the paint, I can scrape it back onto the palette to be used later on. But now I'm picking up the next colour, which is this beige green. If you're using an old store card or credit card, it's probably too difficult to mix the paint using that. So you can use a brush and just get your colour ready on the palette and then use the card to dip into it. I'm mixing some of the darker violet blues with a touch of brown to go over the top and be my clouds. And of course, the beauty of acrylics is that if you don't like what you've done, you can just go back over the top of it. Or even just scrape it off completely.